I'm going to talk to you today about elasticated stems in feeders and how I do it. Elasticated stems are quite interesting. If you have never used an elasticated stem, or your venue doesn't allow one, or the venues you go to don't allow one, no problem. Get the balance, get your rod right, nice soft rods, particularly short rods are brilliant. I don't see a massive advantage with an elasticated stem, but if you're going to a bigger venue or an open more where the carp are a bit larger and you may be casting a little bit further, you need your 11, your 12 foot rod perhaps, something like that, then for me, elasticated stems cannot be beat where allowed. What they allow you to do is when you're playing the fish, your elastic is basically taking all that extra oomph on those lunges, those big lunges, and it allows the hook not to bounce out. So you can play the fish nice and firmly, but it's always keeping the constant pressure on the hook hold. So you're not gonna get a bounce out or anything like that, a tear through. You know, it's probably better for fish on the hook hold. But I understand the reasons why it's not always allowed because it is a fixed rig. But I always use the ICS stems. Now, we do an elasticated ICS stem out of the packet, no problem. Anything that involves elastic in any shape or form, I always get it out and give it a good test, make sure it's okay. But of course, with it being elastic, it doesn't last forever. So what do you do once that elastic goes? So for me, the reason the ICS stem is so good is because it's ribbed. So because it's got all these ribs along it, effectively when it's in your feeder, it doesn't slip around. It doesn't, your feeder grips nicely, but it's actually easy for you to push your feeder off. That's why I like it so much. I also love the little loop at the top because I just like to use a quick change swivel to attach it to the line. So my rod is all ready with a quick snap swivel on the end of the line like this. And I can literally just clip the feeder on and off as I need it. For me, that's nicer and easier than taking the tail rubber off, undoing it from a loop or however it might be. I like to do everything as quick as possible. So I love just having my swivel on there. Keeps everything nice and it stops spin and all sorts. It's just a really, really good way of doing it. So I love these stems and I've used them for ages, but what do you do when that elastic perishes? So I'm gonna show you, it is so easy to redo your elastic and I cannot take credit for this. Good friend of mine, Neil McKinnon, showed me how to do this about 4 or 5 years ago and I've done it and it's never ever let me down because what you wanna do is something easy that's not gonna effectively burn or damage on your line. So all you need is your stem with your elastic taken out. You need an off cut of 13 hollow. There's only one elastic for your stem. It's 13 hollow. That's the only one you want, right? That is the perfect elastic for these short stems. And you want a little rig ring. For me, I like a little rig ring. Then I can just clip my hook length on, do whatever I like. Because when you're using elastic, you can reuse the connector it comes with if you want to, no problem whatsoever. But for me, I can just do a nice easy knot with this rig ring. So dead simple to use. So I'm gonna show you how to do it now, really easy. So what you need to do is go through the bottom first of your, this little connecting part at the top of the stem, and then come back through the top, all right? And what you're gonna do is on the top piece, just a one turn overhand knot like so. All right, so just literally a simple granny knot if you like there at the top, and then get your elastic and thread it through that granny knot and pull the whole thing down tight. Now, always remember, you can see it's kind of like a bit of a lasso. Always remember, whenever you're doing everything with this, wet up your knot and your elastic. It'll slip dead easy if you do that. And once it grips down, hollow elastic does not come undone. So give that a good wet. And then literally what you're looking to do is effectively pull this tight and then pull the knot tight down onto the stem. So just steady pressure. You don't want to be going nuts. It almost like just finds its place, dead steady. Don't pull it dead hard. And then pull the other tag nice and tight. And there you go, look. That is absolutely not going anywhere. It hasn't damaged the elastic in any way. I always like to pull it tight, check there's no damage. Yep, absolutely perfect elastic with that knot holding tight down on it. So that's bang on. I can trim that off at the top there. You can trim that nice and tight. That's not going to slip at all. I just leave a couple of mil tag just through habit that you could tie it right down to the knot. And then thread the elastic through the stem. So just push the rest of the elastic through the stem. And once you've got it through, give it a good pull, bottom it out, give it a hold for sort of 5-6 seconds. one, you're testing the knot, but two, you're making sure that elastic's nice and stretched, because this is elastic's going to take some hammer, so you want it tensioned perfectly. And then all you need to do, literally the easiest knot of all time, is get your rig ring, thread it onto your elastic, put your rig ring down to the end of the stem there like that, and all you're doing is tying us one simple overhand granny knot, I'm calling it, look, around the rig ring. Just make sure the tension's right, wet the knot, and just steadily, again, you're not pulling it hard, but just harder and harder and harder. There you go, it can't go any further. Trim that off, and there you have the most perfect, I'm just going to hook this up to show you, the most perfect elasticated stem that's going to last for ages and not let you down, ready to go. I always do these every year. I do these in the spring now for my feeder fishing campaign, and I won't change these out until October, ready for my winter campaign. That's it, dead easy to do. I've got all them ready to go, hopefully go and catch a few fish.